So let's take a look at a new type of chart that's available in number of versions 5.0 just released the other week for Mac. This new type of chart is called a donut chart, and it's very similar to a pie chart. Let's start with a simple table like this, where it's just a single basic row of data. And normally for a pie chart you would select the data. I just selected the entire table there. I'm going to hit chart and I'm going to select the pie chart. And this is what I get as a result here. I get a pie chart that shows me the division between the numbers. There's just six of them here. And it's pretty basic when we're used to that. But a donut chart, while displaying information that's very similar, it's a little different. I'm going to select all again and I'm going to click chart, and then you can see the new donut chart right here. I'll select that, and now you can see it basically is like a pie chart, but the center is hollow. Now the advantages of this depends on your theory of charts and what sort of graphs and things you want to use in your presentations and your spreadsheets and all of that. One of the advantages is you can put something in the middle here. In fact, if I select it here and I go to Format and then Chart and Title, you can see it actually puts the title there in the center rather than at the top or the bottom or somewhere else. So you can save a little space and not have to have something outside like that. Another thing about it that people talk about is the visual aspect of it, that our eye is a little bit better at looking at these basically curved bars. It's like a curved bar chart almost. And identifying the percentages of, like, you know, this purple band here versus this blue band. We're better at doing that with our brains than doing it in a pie chart where it's all filled in with a wedge. So there's those kinds of advantages, and also it's kind of the style now. It's the more interesting style. You see it in a lot of infographics. You see it in a lot of presentations. So that's why it's been added. Now there's a lot of different things that you can do to customize it, just similar to the other charts. You can, like I said, put the title there. You've got the legend there at the top. You can have that on or off. Title position can go to the top if you really wanted to. You can do all sorts of different things. Background fill, you know, change it to a gradient, color, make it something besides white, for instance, if you really wanted to do that. The shadow, you can have shadow over the different bars, individuals, or all as one group, so the entire thing's got a shadow to it. There is no 3D version of the donut chart, unlike pie chart, so that's something to consider. You can, for individual segments, change different things. So for instance, if I wanted to highlight a specific segment, I can click it there and you could see I could change its order. I can change it to a name and then get rid of the value like that. And I could select all of these segments and do that for all of them. And I could even change the leader line type, for instance, or actually have the number embedded inside of the bar there. And I can pull it out to have its distance from center. It's a good way to highlight a specific item in there. So a lot of things you can do. You can do those with pie charts as well. Donut charts are just a really good new addition to Numbers, and it brings it kind of up to date with a lot of other spreadsheets that now offer them. And as you can expect, you can also use these donut charts inside of Pages and inside of Keynote as well.